الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وإمامنا وقائدنا رسول الله محمد صلى الله وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي البهي وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the master of the whole universe, the creator, the sustainer, the provider, the cherisher, the one who created us to worship him. And I bear witness openly that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah. And I bear witness openly that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. Whoever Allah guides, no one can misguide him. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let him to be astray, no one can bring him back to the guidance except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Welcome everyone to the third day of Ramadan and to the online iftar program. And we have, as usual, alhamdulillah, we tried to unite the three communities together in that session, in that virtual session. And that's why, alhamdulillah, we have our Imam Jalal, Imam Masjid al-Rahman of Tarburn Spring. Assalamu alaikum, Shaykhana.
Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ya ahlan wa sahlan. Nice. Welcome everybody. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Jazakallah khairan. Nice to have you, Imam. And please welcome our brothers and sisters from the different communities.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Amen. Day by day, alhamdulillah, increasing the number day by day. It's very important, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, for everyone to get before the iftar and sharing even the iftar. It is really a great atmosphere, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. May Allah bless you. Ameen.
You know what, Imam Galal, let me tell you frankly, in front of everyone, so they will be witnessed, that I love you for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Jazakum Allah khairan, my dear respect brother. May Allah bless you and your family. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us all together in Jannah, including Imam Sheikhna Muhammad Yahya, inshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen. Gather us all together, inshaAllah.
Yes, let me welcome Imam Yahya, Imam Masjid al-Salam in Dunedin. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh Muhammad.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome everybody.
You see, mashallah, you look at you, handsome man, and mashallah, young sheikh and young imam, Allahu Akbar.
Yeah, it's not too young, but it's alhamdulillah. I'm good.
No, he talk about me, my brother.
Imam Jalal is still in his 20s, yes.
May Allah bless you.
Allahumma ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. So let's go for our introduction today. We are actually chose one of the verses in Surah Al-Baqarah, which talks about Ramadan, about the virtues of Ramadan, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exactly honored this month, and why Ramadan is so special. And you may have non-Muslims, and they ask this question, why Ramadan is so special? And we have a clear answer, alhamdulillah, because Ramadan is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had sent the Quran in it to the heart of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam through the revelation of and through the angel Jibril. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Baqarah, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. It is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down the Quran to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And yes, of course, we have lots of discussions among the scholars about, did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send the entire Quran to the Prophet Muhammad, or just Allah, what the beginning of the revelation was in Ramadan, or as Imam Ibn Abbas said in the tafsir, that أنزل الله القرآن جملة واحدة من اللوح المحفوظ إلى السماء الدنيا ثم نزل مفصلا بحسب الأحداث والوقائع. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had revealed the Quran one shot from the preserved tablet to the first sky, to the first heaven, then it was gradually was revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imam Jalal, I just wanted you to shed the light on this topic about why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored this month, and what is the significance of revealing the Quran and sending the Quran down during the month of Ramadan.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد, my dear respected brothers and sisters, welcome again with another day, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, of fasting. another blessing day, another day in the month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this an honor month. And it looks like prepare everything, prepare everything in order to bring the Quran, subhanallah al-azim, just for the Quran. So the whole month of Ramadan, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, it is the month of the Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. So Allah Azza wa Jal choose the month of Ramadan among the 12 months. 12 months, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose the month of Ramadan to be the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran on it. And Allah Azza wa Jal choose the night of the power. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. Also in the month of Ramadan. And Allah Azza wa Jal said also in Surah Sa'd, Subhanallah al-Azim, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ. Even the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this book is the blessing book. Allah Azza wa Jal said also in different surah, in different ayah, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ. In Surah Al-Dukhan, Subhanallah al-Azim. Allahu Akbar. So all this blessing, all this because of the Quran. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَبِالْحَقِّ أَنزَلْنَاهُ وَبِالْحَقِّ نَزَلْ. And we send it by the truth. And it is by the truth, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. All those for the book of Allah, for the Quran. Why? Because the Quran is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The book of Allah Azza wa Jal, glory be to him, is not only for reading, not only for memorizing, but لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ. It is to organize all our life in order to understand everything, all details. Because we're not Muslims only in the house of Allah, in the masjid. We're not Muslims only when we pray and when we say Allahu Akbar. We're not Muslims only at this time, but we are Muslims. We are 24/7 Muslims. So we are all day long Muslims. We treat everybody same, Muslims and non-Muslims. So this is the way it's supposed to be. We are fasting. And fasting, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen, has a lot of benefit. I didn't want to take time because always, you know, the time is chasing me. But I leave space, inshallah, for my respected brother, Sheikh Imam Muhammad Yahya. Inshallah. Jazakumullah khairan.
Jazakumullah khairan, Sheikh Khana. Barakallah subhanahu wa ta'ala fikum. Inshallah, we will get back to the Imam in the final part of this verse, in the explanation of this verse, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس. Allah has sent the Quran down to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and one of the characteristics of this Quran that it have huda, it have guidance for people. So everyone is seeking guidance, go back to the Quran. Everyone is seeking the light in his life. Everyone is seeking for the inner peace. Everyone seeking to strengthen his relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here is the Quran. Go and rush to join yourself with the Quran. And of course, you know me, I like to play these such games so I can have lots of brothers and sisters here. I can, mashallah, Brother Wajdi Shariq, and alhamdulillah, Dr. Rahim, Tihaj, and mashallah, we can see lots of brothers and sisters. I can ask them. Now we are in the third day of Ramadan, so who finished the third juz in from the Quran? So for those people who are opening the camera, just raise your hand. MashaAllah. Allahu Akbar. Shariq, Ibtihaz, Dr. Rahim, Haj Wajdi. Did you finish the third juz? Haj Wajdi, MashaAllah. Sister Rifat didn't. Haj Wajdi in the fourth, MashaAllah. In the fourth juz, Allahu Akbar. Sister Rifat, did you finish the third one? Ya Allah. No, you need to strive. You need to work. MashaAllah, Brother Shariq finished five juz, MashaAllah. Allahu Akbar, Takbir, MashaAllah. You have also, I can see the brothers and sisters still in the hall, Brother Faisal, Hamdan, and Abdul Basit, and Brother Ahsan. And let me tell you, really, really, MashaAllah, they are working very hard, MashaAllah. Allahu Akbar, amazing job that they are doing. And I really, really, MashaAllah, thank Sister Tasnoor and Sister Ruby Alam for all the great work that she is doing. Amazing job. And I'm pretty sure that the other communities also, mashallah, Sister Hind, Sister Jamila, Sister Rifat, and mashallah, Imam Jalal, with Dr. Javid, and all the communities, mashallah, they are doing their best to the happiness of the community. I can see also Brother Muhammad Ali, mashallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. Allahumma ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. So let me go back quickly to the point. If you are seeking guidance, go back to the Quran. Allah said, Hudan linnas. And be aware of that expression. Allah did not say it has the guidance for just the believers. Allah said, linnas. It has guidance for people, for everyone. So let's go back directly to Imam Yahya, because inshallah we are going to enjoy his dua, inshallah, before getting back to Imam Jalal for the adhan. Yes, Imam Yahya, assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum, can you hear me now?
Yes, Imam Jalal.
Is it the time for dua, or we still have some minutes before adhan?
We still have time, inshallah.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala sayyidina rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The words cannot express how this Quran is so beautiful, and it's so sweet, and it's so blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want the guidance in this life, you'll find it in the Quran. And if you want the light and the savage in the hereafter, you should be following the Quran. And if you want the true happiness, you will definitely find it in the Quran. As our brothers said at the beginning, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran in this month, in the month of Ramadan. But I'm going to add something really important. You might be surprised by it. All of us know that, alhamdulillah, we make siyam because it is faridah. It is mandatory to make siyam. And we make siyam also, one of the purposes that we make siyam, that we feel how the poor people feel during the year. And we also discipline ourselves and regulate our lives. And on top of that, we make siyam in the month of Ramadan in order to celebrate the revelation of the Quran. Just imagine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed 30 days in a row, you make siyam in order to celebrate and to feel this happiness and to feel this greatness of the Quran, the nobleness of the Quran in the month of Ramadan. So whenever you know the value of something, you will be appreciating it very well. Absolutely. Whenever you know the value of the Quran, you will try to get closer to the Quran. So how could we get, or how could we extract the benefit and the guidance from the Quran? We have five ways. I'm saying it very quickly. خمسة أمور حينما تتعامل مع القرآن الكريم. التلاوة، الاستماع، الحفظ، التدبر، العمل. التلاوة، الاستماع، الحفظ، التدبر، التطبيق. So if you want to handle, if you want your relationship with the Quran to be continuous, to strengthen your relationship with the Quran, so you need to recite the Quran, to listen to the Quran, to memorize some of the Quran as much as you can, and to contemplate about the meanings of the Quran, and then implementation of the Quran. So read, listen, memorize, contemplate, and then practice what is in the Quran. This is the way how to get the guidance out from the Quran, inshallah. I think we're about to get to the adhan. Right.
Yes, inshallah. Yes, inshallah. We you can go directly to the dua, inshallah. And then Imam Jalal, inshallah, will give us the adhan. Just wanted to say to everyone, for those people who get lazy and don't come to pray Taraweeh after they take iftar, this is not the month that you need to waste. So I urge you, at any masjid, inshallah, with Imam Yahya, with Imam Jalal, at any masjid, go and pray Taraweeh, inshallah. And for those people who wanted to, inshallah, to join us in Newport Richey, do you need to know what Sayyiduna Musa did with the appointment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Sayyiduna Musa one day went to meet Allah, special meeting with Allah. If you wanted to know what he did with Allah, join us in Salah, inshallah. Yes, Imam Yahya.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن الذين هم أهلك وخاصتك اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا ونور صدورنا وذهاب أحزاننا اللهم ذكرنا منهما نسينا وعلمنا منهما جهلنا وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وأطراف النهار اللهم ارفع لنا به الدرجات وكفر عنا به السيئات وهون علينا به السكرات عند الممات اللهم اجعلنا لكتابك من التالين ولك به من العاملين وبالأعمال مخلصين وبالقسط قائمين وعن النيران مزحزحين وفي الجنان منعمين وإلى وجهك الكريم ناظرين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
جزاك الله خيرا. Perfectly, exactly on time. Yes, Imam Jalal, you can open your microphone and start your adhan while I'm holding my date to start breaking my fast, inshallah.
Inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله
الله أكبر الله
أكبر جزاك الله خيرا شيخنا بارك الله فيكم جعل الله ميزان حسناتكم تقبل الله أعمالكم الصالحة آمين رب العالمين
آمين يا رب آمين يا رب. Dear respected brothers and sisters, enjoy your meal. May Allah shower all of us with His mercy. آمين يا رب العالمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.